Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen. It's Thursday, January 24th, 2013. Got a few things to talk to you about here. One of the things to start off with, not too cool. Over the three-day holiday weekend we just went over, we had two drinking and driving incidents. That brings us up to three on the year already. A reminder, if you're going to partake in the adult beverages and the ignorant oil, please do not get behind the wheel of a car. There's other alternatives. Walk, take a bus, take a taxi, take the train. Designate a Liberty Buddy to be a designated driver. Make sure you have a plan. This is already unsat as having three incidents so far, and we're not even out of the first month of the year. So please, CFAY, let's knock that off and be responsible when you drink and don't drive. Reminder that all schools are closed tomorrow, the 25th of January. That's due to a teacher's work day. And on Saturday, if you're interested in the rock band called Vertical Horizon, they will be performing at Benny Decker Theater at 7 p.m. It does not cost anything to get in, but it is first come, first serve. So if you want to get in there, make sure you get over to Benny Decker Theater early on a Saturday evening. There's going to be a repaving project starting here, starting up next week. It's around Berkey Field. That's Clement Boulevard around the Berkey Field area. They're going to be doing some repaving there on the track area where we run the PRT. So maybe when they get the new asphalt down, we'll be able to take a few seconds off our times when we run our mile and a half. But that's going to start, like I said, next week, and it should be repaired around and done around the middle of March. 31 January over at the Chapel of Hope is going to be the annual graduation ceremony. That's for all of you who go over and use the your tuition assistance and works on college degrees over there through Navy campus. So they're going to do the graduation ceremony there at Chapel of Hope. That's going to start at 1400 that day. So last year I think there were 60 some people who received certificates and their diplomas. I don't know what the number is yet this year, but it's always a good moment, a good event, and it's a great accomplishment for all those who are getting your degrees. In February, the 6th through the 8th, we're going to be doing our annual Guard and Protect exercise. That is with the Japanese Ground Self-Defense Forces. So through the 6th through the 8th of February, you'll see some Japanese soldiers running around the base and have their equipment and vehicles. It's part of, like I said, our annual Guard and Protect exercise where we work with them jointly. Hey, there's a little sporting event coming up here, not this weekend, but the following weekend. You might have heard of it, called the Super Bowl. We got quite a few things planned for that. There's going to be a pre-Super Bowl party at Club Alliance starting at 1600 on the 3rd of February. That's on Sunday evening. There will be some special guests there. They'll have a little bit of free food. There'll be chances to win prizes. And the band Jade that plays there will be starting, will kick off at 1900 that evening as well. Then on the day of the Super Bowl, all the clubs will be opening early, somewhere anywhere between 06 to 07:30, depending which club it is. So you can come on out, go to the club. Some of them have breakfast buffets. There'll be other types, more prizes, more special guests there. And then they'll put the football game on, and you can watch the Super Bowl on Monday morning at one of the MWR clubs. Well, speaking of sports, I'll go to Captain's Cup Sports next. Last night in the Captain's Cup Co-Rec Basketball Tournament, the championship was played last night, and CFAY is the champion this year now of the Captain's Cup Co-Rec Basketball. They came in with a real close game between the Blue Ridge. It came down to the last couple of minutes. It was real close. It was a real competition, and everybody played really hard. So congratulations both to CFAY and Blue Ridge on your Captain's Cup Co-Rec Basketball finishings last night. Next week, they're going to start Captain's Cup basketball tournaments. This will be all men's and all women's teams going up against each other. So please, commands, get out there, get into it. What was great that I did not mention there was Sogu 7 did not win the Captain's Cup competition last night for the basketball co-rec. So maybe we're on a roll. Maybe they will get dethroned this year, but we'll see what happens. Okay, going on to sports over at the high school. There were some games that had to be rescheduled, one due to the snow day and two due to exams that were this week. So there's going to be a lot of basketball games coming up here real fast and furious. For example, on Monday, the girls team will be playing. on Wednesday next week, the boys team will be playing. And then next weekend on Friday and Saturday, that's the 1st and 2nd of February, both girls in basketball, and both girls and boys will be playing basketball. Some of the games will be over at Fleet Rec because they're playing at the same time. And there also is going to be a wrestling, there's going to be a wrestling match on Saturday, February the 2nd. So if you're into the high school sports, lots of opportunities come out and support the teams and say go Red Devils next week and next weekend. The base full contact football team, the Seahawks, continues to practice. They're down at Berkey Field Tuesday, Wednesdays, and Thursdays at 17:30. I've walked down there several times and seen them out there. They're trying to get fired up. We want to see if we can get a championship at our adult level sports there in the football this year. So, and if you've got some talent, got some skills, think you can come out. Come on out and talk to Coach Price and see maybe you'd be able to help out the team. For all you golfers, you might have noticed the driving range has been down the last few days. That's when the storm came through. It did receive some damage. NAFAC is doing an assessment of how much of the damage is and what it's going to take to repair it. So right now, I do not have an estimated time of repair for the driving range. We'll keep you updated when we find out exactly what needs to be repaired and how long they think it's going to take. So sorry about that, but it did suffer some damage from the storm that came through. And Spring Festival isn't that far off. Registration for booths ends this week. So if you want to get a booth, you need to get hold of MWR by the end of this week. And the Spring Festival is on the 24th of March. So remember, the 24th of March will be the Spring Festival, our first open base event of the year. All right, on to the trivia. From my last video, the song I was looking for was Keep Your Hands to Yourself by the Georgia Satellites. That was answered by Jeannie Madison. Thank you very much, Jeannie. The question I had for the TV show from Gilligan's Island is, what was the SS Minnow named after? Because it wasn't named after a fish. And it was named after Newton Minow, who happened to be the chairman of the FCC at the time and didn't even like the show and didn't think it should be on the air. And the answer for that one came from Roger Drake. Thank you, Roger. And I had an easy one in the sports world. I asked, how much did a hockey puck weigh? The answer was 5.5 to 6 ounces, and Nicole Henley gave me the answer on that. Now I have three more trivia questions to go. Here's a song. I'll give you lyrics. See if you can tell me an artist and the name of the song. The goalie jumps, and the players bump, and the fans all go insane. All right, so what's the name of that song, and who did it? I'm going to go back for TV. I'm going to go to one of my old favorites, the show about nothing, Seinfeld. In one of the episodes, George discovers a great place for taking a nap during work. Where is it? Where does he take his nap, this great place? Now, I'm not condoning this. I don't want people to go find the same place where they work and take naps during the workday, but this was part of the Seinfeld show. And for a sports question, this one should be pretty easy. You know, the Baltimore Ravens are going to be in the Super Bowl. They're going to be playing the San Francisco 49ers. Who were the Baltimore Ravens before they became the Baltimore Ravens? That was kind of an easy question, but I'll throw it out there anyhow. Who were the Baltimore Ravens before they became the Baltimore Ravens? Well, CFAY, I hope you have a great weekend and stay safe. As a reminder, good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. And good shipmates don't let shipmates get sexually assaulted. Have a great day, CFAY.